are as a son and daughter of the Lord. Kasi nga, from there, you would already see that abundance starts here. It's who you are, knowing who you really are, identity. And from there din, I do believe na after this year, mas matindi pa ang pwede mangyari. Kasi nga, alam na natin kung sino tayo. Kapag nalaman natin kung sino tayo, by next year, iba na naman. May prophetic word na eh. Natatakot ako kapabigla ko na sabi. Kaya feeling ko naman kahit nasabi ko, hindi nyo naman mapapansin yun, di ba? Pero yun nga eh, mas matindi. It's gonna be a far... Kung may isipin pa tayo na mas matindi pa sa abundance, that would be it. And it would be coming this coming 2019. But it has already started. It's in Isaiah. I'm already doing something new. You may not see it. I'm already doing something new. So, siguro this, Christina asked me to exhort for a while. Everything that happened to you guys this year, treat it as a lesson learned. Everything that happened personally, whether in relationships, in finances, in career, or in decisions, treat it as something that made you richer here and here. Kasi dadalhin niya sa 2019. Matinding-matindi. And this is the promise of the season. I think masarap pag Pasko. Ang masarap pag Pasko is that meron kang tatlong regalo. Every perfect gift is from above. Diba sabi sa every good and perfect gift is from above. And I'd like to share three gifts. First gift is joy.
Props!
Maghanap talaga ako. First gift is joy. The joy of the Lord. I mean, if kahit ano pang nangyari sa atin within this year, we have a reason and a cause for joy.
Amen.
Kasi si Lord, hihigitan pa niya. Lahat ng mga meron tayo, hihigitan pa niya. Kung meron naman tayo pinagdaanan na hindi maganda, God will give you double the joy for every trouble that you have experienced.
Amen.
That's joy. And sabi nga, when Jesus Christ came, joy to the world. Joy has been paid through the cross. That's the reason why we can have joy. Kaya pakisabi sa katabi mo, double the joy.
Double the joy.
Joy.
Bobby's chicken.
Second one.
Shades.
Second one is peace. Calmness. Coolness. Kaya nga naka-shake it. Relax ka lang eh.
Chill.
Even though it's a season of deadlines and it's a season na ang dami mong kailangan gawin, maraming nasa-stress, pero eto, tandaan natin, yung mismo peace is a gift. Peace has come, sabi. Peace has come. So sabi nga ni Pastor Anthony, even if there's we are in the midst of the storm, we can say this still. Peace has come. Jesus Christ came to give us the peace. First and foremost, the reason why we can celebrate is because we have a relationship with Jesus Christ. Yun pa lang. Yun pa lang may rason na tayo para nang magpahinga tayo. Kasi the Lord is our shepherd. We shall not lack. And He holds us in the palm of our hands, in the palm of His hands. He anoints us. He covers us. He protects us. Lahat na lang eh. Pwede nga, He showers us with His blessings. He does not take His eye off us. We are the apple of His eye. And He does not sleep. He does not slumber. And He does not leave us, not forsake us. Kung isipin pa lang natin lahat ng ginagawa niya para sa atin, and how He takes care of us, we can be at peace. Even in the midst of the storm, we can sleep. And even in this year, hindi mo man alam kung paano siya matapos. Kung hindi mo maintindihan kung anong mangyari. But still, you can have. And if you, even if you don't know what 2019 holds, it's okay. Because you have a good God. Mm-hmm. You have a good Father. Amen. So we have peace. We have joy. We have peace. We have, of course,
love.
We have love. Maganda kayo rin siya, eh, no? We have love life.
Love life.
Okay, we have love, no? Siguro, this is the most cliche. Cliche natin to. Give love on Christmas Day. Ito na yung pinakapagkakataon para mapakita natin yung pagmamahal natin sa isa't isa pag Pasko. Pero yun nga eh, kahit naman gano'n siya ka-cliche, we could never really out-practice it. Mm. We should always practice it. In the mere fact, yung appreciation nyo, yung pag-saya nyo. You just enjoying each other's fellowship, it is already love. Mm-hmm. I remember Pastor Anthony sharing to us, sabi niyang ganyan, if you want one secret to intimacy, is enjoyment. When you never we are in the presence of people, you don't have to perform it. You don't have to pretend. Just enjoy. Enjoy each other's company. And that is already in itself, loving them. Kasi hindi ka mag-pretend, hindi ka na nag-pretend, hindi ka nagbabalat kayo. Wala, you're just enjoying simply each other. And hindi mo kailangan ikulong ang sarili mo. Amen.
Amen.
Yan naman ang kasarapan kapag na we are one family. We know that we are all children of the Lord and we do not need to compete with one another. Except for the prices, siguro. Pero yun nga, ito yung kasarapan sa isang pamilya. Because we know God loves us, we can love one another with security. And we can... It's okay if others would shine. It's okay if they would be better than us. Kasi sigurado naman, meron binigyan ng Panginoon sa atin. Kung saan doon tayo, make it shine. Pero yun nga eh, we can love them, we can accept people, we can forgive them. We can start anew. Because yung pinakamotivation natin is love. Siguro just to end it, sharing to you again, once again, just Lego relationship, I Lego principle. How handling relationships. Trust is love is the motivation for any relationship. Trust is the foundation. So, kayo siguro, yung mga matatagal na dito magkakakilala, you already know one another and so you trust one another. But as time goes by, you learn to trust more. You learn to trust deeply. So, yun ngayon kasi is the foundation. And then after, forgiveness is the restart button. Kapag nagkamali, pwede nang mag-umpisa ulit. And nag-umpisa ka lang ulit, forgiveness. And then communication makes a relationship grow. A relationship cannot grow without communication. Hindi pwedeng nag-grow kayo pero hindi mo kayo nag-grow. Importante yung communication. Pero yun nga, yung motivation ng lahat-lahat ng mga yan. The reason why you forgive, the reason why you communicate, the reason why you trust is because you love. And that is applicable in all relationships. Not just the married ones, it's not just the friends, it's not just the love, like no, it's all relationships. Kaya magbalik na. Love is a gift. And the reason why we can love is to accept that is for God so loved the world. That it would be his one and only son. That whosoever to him shall not perish. We have joy. We have peace. We have love. Overflowing. Because of Christ. Amen. Amen. Can I pray for you guys?
Yes.
Let's pray. Bow your heads. We're going to pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, for giving us a reason to celebrate. Salamat po, binigyan niyo po yung Disyembre para po na alalahanin po na yung hanggang po po para po po po. Salamat po, binigyan niyo po yung sasa na ito para po muli po namin balikan ang pinakamagandang regalo na binigyan niyo po sa akin. And that is your son, Jesus. Because of him, Lord, we are showered with every spiritual blessing in heaven. But because of him, Lord, we have joy, we have peace, we have love, we even have hope, God. Because, Lord, you are the God who never fails. You are the God who never disappoints. And I speak, God, right now, Lord, sa bawat puso po na narinig. Lord, I speak, Lord, that brand new hope instilled in their hearts, Lord. That increasing faith right now, like a fresh fire, Lord. Believing, Lord God, that this year will end, Lord, in triumph and in faith. And Lord, each person in this place, Lord, will have a fresh fire. And Lord, that their faith will be ready for more of what you're going to do for 2019.
Yes.
Father, Lord, bless each of their families. Bless each family represented in this place. Bless their hearts. Bless their relationship with you. Bless them, Lord God, with more of you and less of us. Bless them, Lord God. We know that you said in your word, delight yourself in you, and you will give the desires of our hearts. You are our desire, Lord. Everything else is a bonus. Bless them with joy and overflowing joy this end of the year, Lord. And mag-overflow po siya hanggang 2019. Salamat po. Bless the rest of the night. And God, we love you, for you have loved us first. We give you glory, we give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Well, I remember when Nacha was parang having this one big group, yung tatlong statements na honor the past. They honor the past.
Honor the past.
Bless.
Honor the past.
Seize the present. Seize the present. Say, seize the present.
Seize the present.
And lastly, bless the future. So that's actually basically what we're doing right now. We are honoring what God has done for the days of 2018. Amen. Lucky all the good things na ginawa ni Lord, celebrate natin. And this moment, we are seizing this moment with one another, showing, enjoying in the presence of one another. And at the same time, always remember that we're crossing it. We're on the crossroad. We're going to 2019. And no one knows what the future holds for us, right? So what we can do at this moment is to bless the future.
Amen.
Bless 2019. And so that's why this gathering is also called Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving for the past years, past months, and then blessing the future, 2019. Para we'll have our hearts ready facing 2019. And the thing here is, ako I did this Christmas, I committed to this no stress Christmas season. Diba naka-stress kapag na Christmas season lagi, no? So I had this little manifesto, no stress Christmas season. I promised myself not to go into any Christmas sale or any Christmas rush or anything. So I could preserve ready myself and face 2019. So we could all also do that. Amen?
Amen.
So, ayan po. Thank you again, Ashley. Let's give God a big hand.
Married na
ulit. Bring home the
bacon.
Wow! Bring home the bacon.
So,
kaya
nasa appreciation.
Wait, Nacha, picture mo tayo.
Picture.
Wait, Nacha.
Class picture.
Selfie na lang para.
Selfie.
Hindi ba here?
Okay, so,
nice to meet you all.
Yes. So,
then, before tayo formalization, thanks so much.